So I know nobody in showbiz in real life, but I actually know Steve Mazur, pretentious Steve from the radio days,
yes.
And of course, several screenplays to his credit, and now a brand new movie. Do people bring, I don't know, when you are in a meeting, do people go, wait, you were one of the guys who wrote Liar Liar?
When I have a meeting every couple of years, they do bring it up. It's a nice credit to have, yeah.
There we go. Does Jim Carrey call you on a regular basis?
Oddly enough, no.
new
but
movie.
The cop.
He does.
Right. He calls me sometimes. Working for work.
Cop
so.
Number B.
Cop number yeah. B. And in a screenplay, do you list it as cop number B?
No, it would be cop number one, cop number two.
Right. Okay. Oh, yeah.
Please, we're professional.
There's a numerical designation. Yeah. All right, new movie. It's called Phil. Greg Kinnear stars and his directorial debut. How does that come about? Does he say to you, Steve, I need a movie to direct?
Well, there's a producer named Sandy Stern who did Being John Malkovich and several other great movies. And so we kind of hooked up. And I worked with Sandy for about a year developing the script. And then he got it to Greg Kinnear. And then I worked with Greg for about a year working on the script. And it was fantastic. Both are great guys. And it was just a wonderful experience for me.
And when people use that phrase, developing, is that just like lunch, or what does that really mean?
Well, it's a series of lunches, right. As you can tell. I've had my share of lunches.
Right.
But and they're reading the scripts, and there's a lot of notes and back and forth and discussing scenes, and it's quite very specific.
So when this first started percolating, Bradley Whitford was here, and Bradley Whitford is in the movie, and this is all off air. I said to Bradley Whitford, oh, this friend of mine wrote Phil, and Bradley Whitford said, and he just in an honest way, he goes, I'm not bragging. I get everything. I get every single script for the second guy, not to be the lead, but to be the second guy, every single one. This is the best script I've ever read.
Wow. Wow.
And I called you and told you. No, he just went on and on about it.
Well, that's great. And it's a great cast. It's Emily Mortimer is in it, and the great Luke Wilson. I'm checking my list.
Yeah, come on.
Because I'll get sued if I don't mention certain people. But and it was a terrific experience from start to finish. And I'm really proud of the movie. Mm. I mean, I love it.
Oh, well, here we go. Let's. I will show you a little clip from it. This is from the trailer, I think.
Detective McGuire, I'm Michael Fisk.
Fisk, yeah.
How am I looking?
Perfect.
Michael Fisk was this guy who I thought had figured it all out. And then he killed himself. I need to find the reason why.
I need another drink.
I'm looking for a report on the death of Michael Fisk.
Your name?
My name is Spiros.
Spiros.
Spiros Papalapadopoulou.
Spiros? From Greece?
Yes.
I'm sorry, I didn't get your name.
Who are you?
This is Michael's friend.
Spiros.
Great.
Oh, wow.
All right. I mean, obviously, you mentioned the cast. Lots of people there and sort of heartfelt stuff. I don't know. When you're writing a big emotional scene, are you sobbing at the keyboard?
You know, I remember the New Yorker did an article on a big screenwriter who, and they made fun of him because he was crying while he was reading his script. I think that's the greatest thing ever. You know, it needs to move you if you're going to try to move an audience. So I can't say that I wept myself while writing it, but I mean, I definitely am trying to bring in as much emotion as I can.
Well, you have an opportunity to see it. There's special screenings this week, just down the street, the Arena Cinelounge, starting today, tomorrow, I should say, through July 11th. Ticket information at their website, arenascreen.com. Several showings over the weekend. I think a bunch of us are planning to go to see it on Friday, so excited about that. Last time Steve and Jessica were together, it was a roast for me.
Hey, that was fun, wasn't it?
It was fun.
When people roast Sam?
Yes.
That's a good time.
I went a little long. I just could see you in the corner going.
A lot of material.
last time Steve and I saw each other, we sat in a fine Russian restaurant.
I was telling Mark, the last time I saw you, it was at a Russian restaurant, and I had never gotten so drunk in my life.
Well, memories.
They couldn't get me out of there, and the valet crew was going to take me to an alley and beat me up. I'm an annoying drunk. So, right. But any event.
I tell you what,
on that note,
the memories. Very good.
Nice memories. Yes, thank you, Sam.
Thank you.
Good to see everybody.
Happy
thank you.
You.